Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Mitchell here, the manager of the Bill Nell Art Show. Today is our fourth episode of our YouTube channel show, and Bill's going to show you just how versatile he can be by not just doing landscapes and clown girl faces, but doing other pieces of art, any kind of art, really, and you're going to get to see that today. And if you have any questions or comments about anything, leave them in the section below. Make sure you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and go visit our website, www.billnellart.com, and we'll see you next time. Thanks.
Afternoon, we're gonna start painting sheepdogs. I do a lot of animals for people, dogs, cats, you know, people's babies. Today, I'm using a 24 by 18 canvas, and I've already put liquid white on it, but it's got a base on it already. I paint a wet on wet. I like that technique because the paints really flow. So I'm going to mix a little sap green and titanium white together. I'm going to put the grass in. Two-inch brush here, and I'm gonna pull some lamp black out, put a little blue with it, and we'll add some white. And we're gonna make this dog. Let's put him right about here. I'll do the outline. Be the other leg, and we'll use this black. Get a little black on there. I'm just pretty much drawing with my brush here. See those brush strokes? How nice it looks. Makes it look like hair. Keep working it, like putting together a puzzle almost. Yeah. A little more black here. I'm just looking at the iPhone I'm putting in what I think I see here. Whites now. Let's see. I'm gonna put his head right about, starts right about there. Paint a lot of animals for people. They like children. They love their pets. Everybody loves their pets. And we got some white feet down in here, this area. Basically, all I'm doing is putting a little background colors in. We're gonna get to the detail later. These dogs here are pretty easy to paint. They got a lot of hair on them. Long-haired dog. They're a big dog too. I did most of that. I put a little bit of paint thinner on it and thin it a little bit. Make me be able to put some in here. Thin it out a little bit with the paint thinner, it makes it stick better. I like that though, that technique. You can see I'm getting a little gray in there, and there's a little gray in here too, so it doesn't matter. Take my brush. You want to be careful with the direction of your paint. But you see how that's coming together. And do a little at a time. And we got some more down in here. Get a touch more to paint thinner. Probably a little more advanced painting than the last ones I've done. But just take your time. It's probably going to take a little longer than normal. Because I will experiment till I get it the way I like it. Touching it lightly. Yeah, it's pulling that white off of there. And I'll get a little on my fan brush. Fan brushes are good for making dog hair. They do an excellent job. I'll just brush them on there. Doing is just dabbing it mostly. But you can see how nice the fan brush does. It makes it look like fur. How nice the foot turned out. And I'll do this one. Just hitting it a little bit. And I'll do this one over here. He's got a little bit on that area. Just tapping it a little bit. And I'll put some of that in. line going like that. May have to give me some more white. You got these areas coming down here like this. Just keep putting it in until you get it where you want it. I guess you can see this. Using the bristles of the brush, make the dog hairs. It's all about technique in this one. Get it to where you like it. And I'm going to use my flamp black. It's pretty fluid. And a lot of times on a steady hand I use this ruler. And this is the case where I want one. So we will use the ruler. I'm going to put his eyeball in right about here. Just use the black for that. And the more you do, you can kind of see the image of it. Matter of training your eye, what exactly am I looking at? What do I see? That's what painting's all about. Training your eyes, seeing what you see. And see how I'll go back over that a little. I got it too dark. Mixing some of the gray with the white. I'm gonna get back, get more white. Detail in right there. Well, you can see I'm getting there. Where his feet is, you gotta plant him on the ground. What I mean by that, you know, it looks like he's floating, so what I do is take my palette knife now. Put some little shadows in here where his feet is. And it can look like he's walking here. Dog's walking here. Little shadows in here. I'm just scraping it pretty much. He's walking. I'm gonna work on the grass a little more too. All in due time. We need to work on this footing a little bit more. Dogs have some big feet or a lot of fur. I'm getting there. Let's keep working it. Go back with the green a little bit and put in some of the grassy areas. Contrast up in here. Taking my 2-inch brush and putting little grass areas in. Put some around his feet area too. Make him stand out a little. And I'll take it like that. Let me get this bottom area right here. Just dabbing it. Put this back. gives it a little contrast, so you don't have it all the same green. You know, you have different shades of green. You put the lighter areas closer to you. You put the darker areas away from you, because you don't actually see them as well, but up close, you know. And that's why I'm gonna add a little blue in it right up in here and make it even darker. I need a little gray in there. Yeah, like that. Darker areas up in here. Makes your eye go to the center of the painting. That's what you want. I draw to the subject matter. It's all about contrast technique. See there? I'll finish this corner off right there. And some of this real dark up in here. Actually adding a little Persian blue lamp black in there. What it does, it gives your picture contrast. And pull a little area down in here like this little, this grass spot needs cutting almost. Good, I like it. And we're gonna put some dark areas around here. Wipe some of this off here. It'll be easier to do. I'll wipe off where I want to bring his head up. Just take a rag. See, I'm getting down to that white. You can see, I'm getting down to that white. And you're going to have to scrape off sometimes. It's just the way it is when you're painting. You don't like something, just scrape it off. You think about oil, they don't dry real quick. And I'm kind of putting in, you see where I'm going to put in the head. I'm going to put it right about there. See, don't that look better already? I haven't put any paint on there yet. And it's coming out right about here. I'm going to come down like right in here. There you go. It looks better already. I hadn't put the paint on there. Getting the outline. I'll put a little paint. I'm just dabbing the paint on. Yeah. A little paint on my brush here. Looks predicament. How you can do that. So I didn't see that until I took the picture, and I said, well, I got my proportions a little bit off. No big deal. Scrape it off and do it over. Painting should be fun. It ain't supposed to be something you dread doing. If you don't enjoy doing it, don't do it. Don't worry about making a mistake. People worry about that when they get to where they can scrape paint off. It's when you really get good, because everybody has scraped paint off. Read something about the masters. They had to go through an apprenticeship program. And the old guys are really rough on them. And you think about Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci. Nobody was born coming out of the womb and painting. You had to learn it all. They went through apprenticeship programs. And they didn't make a lot of money either. A lot of them didn't get famous till after they died. But you can see how nice this is coming out. I'm just putting a little paint in the areas that I wiped off earlier. Using this brush. Put a little shadows in here with this feet areas. What I'll do is use some green. Use some darker green for the shadows. And I'm going to put them right about here. I'm just brushing it in here. Again, all I'm doing is hitting it with the side of my brush. It helps to, yeah, it sits him down, but it's not floating anymore once you do that. Darken this around, make the outline of his face more dominant. Yeah, I'll just blend it a little bit. I don't want it to be white. I don't want that dark here. See the lines too much. Yeah, like that better. I like that better. And actually, we're gonna call that done. We're gonna sign it. So I'm gonna do my first initial, which is W.